Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this inaugural Mass that we begin to open this church for worship again. With the permission of the Bishop, we will be celebrating the patronal feast of the Carmelite Order, the Solemnity of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. And we thank her intercession, and we also ask for your prayers as we continue to give praise to God for His blessing, also protection for our families and our loved ones. Let us confess our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Here.
Let us pray. All gracious God, may the prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother and Queen of Carmel, protect us and bring us to your holy mountain, Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah climbed to the top of Carmel and bowed down to the earth, putting his face between his knees. "Now go up," he told his servant, "and look out to the sea." He went up and looked. "There is nothing at all," he said. "Go back seven times," Elijah said. The seventh time the servant said, "Now there is a cloud small as a man's hand rising from the sea." Elijah said, "Go and say to Ahab, harness the chariot and go down before the rain stops you." And with that, the sky grew dark with cloud and storm, and rain fell in torrents. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Draw us after you, Virgin Mary. We shall follow in your footsteps.
Draw us after you, Virgin Mary, we shall follow in your footsteps.
Lord, who shall be admitted to your tent and dwell on your holy mountain?
Draw us after you, Virgin Mary, we shall follow in your footsteps.
He who walks without fault, he who acts with justice, and speaks the truth from his heart.
Draw us after you, Virgin Mary, we shall follow in your footsteps.
He who does not slander with his tongue, he who does no wrong to his brother, who casts no slur on his neighbor.
Draw us after you, Virgin Mary, we shall follow in your footsteps.
Who holds the godless in disdain, who honors those who fear the Lord.
Draw us after you, Virgin Mary, we shall follow in your footsteps.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. When the appointed time came, God sent his son, born of a woman, born a subject of the law, to redeem the subjects of the law and to enable us to be adopted as sons. The proof that you are sons is that God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, the Spirit that cries, "Abba, Father," and it is this that makes you a son. You are not a slave anymore. And if God has made you son, then he has made you heir. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Water, meet me, sir.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. Seeing his mother and the disciple he loved standing near her, Jesus said to his mother, "Woman, this is your son." Then to the disciple he said, "This is your mother." And from that moment, the disciple made a place for her in his home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our Lady of Mount Carmel, frankly, as a Carmelite after all these years, I always wonder why Mount Carmel. And maybe today I can give a little bit of an instance. Sorry, my glasses are fogging up, I can't see a thing. So, mountain. The first read, the Elijah climbed the mountain of Carmel where he witnessed rain. Our Lady, the Magdalene, and the other two Marys also climb a mountain, and that is Calvary. For those of us who are more adventurous, or more so-called like the outdoors, for those of us who have attempted to go and climb mountains, which I think probably none, you would know that climbing the mountain cannot be taken lightly. We need to train. We need also, in a sense, determination. And also, we need a guide. Our Lady of Mount Carmel, in choosing the image of Carmel, is also telling us, especially for us Carmelites, that the journey to God and the journey of the Christian life is that of climbing the mountain. We have to do it alone, but yet also we would have a guide. There would be many people attempting to climb, but not many would make it to the top. Yeah? Not many would persevere right to the end, to the top. Look at the apostles. At the first so-called mountain halfway on the Mount of Olives, they already dispersed. Only Our Lady was throughout the way. If you like the analogy, the way up the mountain is what you see around you, the 14 stations. That's the way.
The reward is not immediate. not know me, but call me. The reward comes later. The resurrection is a moment that we can only wait for God to reveal. For me, this is a very sobering thought. And actually, as we open this church, it is a bittersweet experience, isn't it? Somehow, we are happy that we are here, but there is also a certain sense of uncertainty. Isn't this also the way up the mountain? We look to Our Lady as guide because throughout the way of the cross, which according to the second reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians, started from the moment Our Lord was born. For those of us who meant our journey as Christians, if we want to remain Christians and we choose to walk as Christians, also start from the moment of our baptisms. Yeah. And the way up the mountain
is hard. We will see gore before we see glory. We must be patient enough to wait and allow the Lord to reveal. In the Gospels, there was never any illusion. The Lord never promises us glory in this life, but everlasting joy in the next. So in celebrating Our Lady of Mount Carmel, we celebrate her as also God's faithful guide, because she was our Lord's faithful companion all the way from birth to the tomb. So let's call on her when the going gets really tough. Queen Beauty of Carmel, pray for us.
Full devotion to our Blessed Mother in our hearts, we turn our eyes.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Carmelite family of France, nuns, secular members all over the world, that they may be the life of allegiance to Jesus Christ and constant prayer, give glory to the Most Holy Trinity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all young people, that through listening and reading the Word of God, they may know of God's love for them, live with faith and hope, and discover their true vocation in life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the depressed, the disabled, and those facing all sorts of difficulties in life, that they remain steadfast in the love of God and put all their trust in God, who never fail to answer our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord. For the relatives, friends, benefactors, and volunteers of Carmel, who reflect the love and kindness of God through their generosity, we ask Him to shower His abundant grace and blessing upon each and every one. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of us present here, let us pause for a moment in silence to pray for our own intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, may our prayers be heard and those of the prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Immaculate of Carmel, guide and protect us, and bring us into your holy.
Mother,
Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we dwell always and everywhere to give you thanks as we honor the Blessed Church of Mary, Mother of Carmel. Your word filled her heart and inspired all her actions, making her constant in prayer with the apostles, as we were shared in our salvation, constantly with her, the spiritual mother of all mankind. She watches unceasingly with her mother's loving care over the brethren of her Son, and lights us along our pilgrim way to the mount of your glory, our beacon of comfort, and the embodiment of all our hopes as members of the Church. Now with all the saints and angels, we praise you for ever.
So
in memory of me.
Recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Yeah.
Lord God, we have been nourished by the blood and body of your Son. May the wonders of your love strengthen us and help us to follow more faithfully the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to whose service we are dedicated. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for your support and prayers for our community. We have all been well. Thank you very much. And I think we have learned the value of solitude in a greater manner that we would maybe we need to get more used to when we meet you again face to face. Yeah. So if we were to become more Tao, forgive us, okay? Because we are more used to being quiet for a while. Thank you for your patience. We hope that this will continue to allow us to worship together. This is to keep us safe, so be patient with the volunteers who are trying their best to make everything as seamless as possible, okay? Thank you for your patience, and we ask for God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. Father chose Mary to be the mother of his Son. May he make you also her faithful children. God the Son was born of Mary and was obedient to her. May he grant you to love her as he did. The Holy Spirit overshadowed her and made her fruitful with the word. May he fill you also with the divine presence.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.